Welcome to this course on Software Conceptual Design. This course is a primer to a full-fledged software engineering course. One of the things that we will do in this course is to take an e-commerce application and deconstruct it and see what are the components in it and how it is constructed in order to understand this process of software conceptual design.
In this course, we will also take you through why it's important to create a conceptual design and have an integrated view of the system before you start coding. One of the many ways that you could do is by using the function behavior structure framework. We will take you through a learning environment, namely ThinkinLink, that will help you to create an integrated view of the system.
So after you come up with the software conceptual design, it is also important that you evaluate this design so that it satisfies the intended requirements of the system. In this course, we will be going through a learning environment called VeriSim, which will help you effectively evaluate a software design against the given requirements.
In addition to doing software conceptual design using the environment ThinkinLink, as well as evaluation of the design using the environment VeriSim, you will also be looking at various software design models such as the V model, Agile and so on, which typically you would encounter in a software engineering course. More details of such models and other steps in software design and development will be encountered in another course on software engineering. Welcome to this course, which is the primer called Software Conceptual Design. Happy learning.